Students of Standard 7, we'll begin with lesson number 2. The title of your second lesson is Exploring Puzzles. Exploring Puzzles, the lesson begins with a very nice story of Akbar Birbal. Okay, so first of all, as I keep reading from the textbook, I'll also explain. You have written the main points on the board. Plus, the story is quite short. Okay, so on page number 12, okay, activity 1. The first paragraph it's written, read the story and also find out the meanings of the words that you find difficult. I've already written the meanings on the board. So as I explain you, I'll also point towards the meanings so that your work becomes easy. Okay. Now the story begins with Emperor Akbar was a great and wise ruler and he had fine advisors in his court. Okay, so Emperor Akbar, we know Emperor Akbar is very famous as far as Indian history is concerned. And we also know that he had 9 gems in his court and one of them was Birbal. His favorite courtier was Birbal. And why Birbal? Because you know he always had an intelligent answer, a good reply to give. He always used to think wisely and then give the answer to Akbar's questions. And that is why he was the wisest among all the courtiers that Emperor Akbar had. So, okay. But the wisest of these was Birbal. Whenever the emperor thought of a difficult problem or puzzle, he turned to Birbal. So whenever there was any problem, there was any puzzle, the emperor would turn to Birbal for his for the solution of his problem. One pleasant evening in March, Akbar was strolling in his courtyard. So the story begins how? That Emperor Akbar was strolling in his courtyard. Strolling means just walking leisurely. Say you just go for a, say sometime in the evening you are free and you just go for a walk. That is called strolling. Strolling means walk in a slow, relaxed way. That is strolling. So Emperor Akbar was strolling in his courtyard. He had just completed a successful military campaign in the east and wanted a little amusement. Now see over here. Akbar, he had just completed a successful military campaign. So, successful military campaign, it shows what? That he must have won some battle. In the eastern part of India, he must have won some battle. And now, because he has won it, he is relaxed. And now, what is the thing that he wants some amusement? Amusement means he wants some entertainment. He wants to have some fun. So, for the sake of fun, he asks questions to his courtiers. Suddenly, he turned to his courtiers and said, "Tell me what should be the punishment for someone who dared to tweak your emperor's mustache." Okay, so Akbar asked his courtier, what this was the question. What should be the punishment for someone who dared to tweak your emperor's mustache? Tweaking the mustache means tuning the mustache. Okay, tweaking, mustache means mooch. Tweaking means tuning the mustache. If somebody comes to tweak your emperor's mustache. Now see, he was a very big emperor. Akbar used to rule a very large part of India. And he was such a great emperor that no one would dare to go and touch the emperor. Okay. And over here he is talking about tweaking the emperor's mustache. That's really a very big thing. Okay, so this is the question that he asks his courtier. What should be the punishment for a person who tweaks your emperor's mustache? So now see all the courtiers. They started thinking about an answer. And so the reply started coming from the courtiers. The courtiers were shocked at this thought. The courtiers were shocked, why? Because Akbar was such a big emperor, who could dare to go near the king and moreover not only go near the king, also tweak his mustache. That was a very big thing. Only the most foul criminal would dare to do such a thing with the king. So what is Emperor Akbar saying? Only the most, what are the courtiers thinking? Only the most foul criminal would do it. Only a person who is a very big criminal can dare to tweak the emperor's mustache. So now the first reply came from Shahbaz Khan. Shahbaz Khan is the name of a courtier. Okay. And what is Shahbaz Khan saying? My lord, the villain should be mercilessly flogged to death. Okay, mercilessly flogged to death. Mercilessly means without kindness. बिल्कुल उस पर दया नहीं खाओ. Without kindness, he should be flogged. Flog means to beat with a whip. चाबुक से मारना, that is called flogging. Okay. Mercilessly flogged to death. And you flog him so much that the person would die. So this is the punishment that Shahbaz Khan suggested. Beheaded in full public view, your honor, said Mullah Dopiazam. Now the second reply came from a courtier whose name is Mullah Dopiazam. And what is Mullah Dopiazam saying? Beheaded in full public view. What should be the punishment? He should be beheaded. Means his head should be cut. In full public view means when all the people are standing. When all the people have gathered at that time, his head should be cut. This should be the punishment for this criminal. Beheaded in full public view, your honor. Your honor, he is using the word your honor for the king. Like when Shahbaz Khan also said, he said, my lord. My lord means he is addressing the emperor. So they have to use such words. My lord, your honor. Okay. Now the third reply. The villain should be thrown down from the fort or be hanged. Now what is the third reply? That was from Shadi Shah. He is another courtier. And what is he saying? He should be thrown down from the fort or be hanged. Okay. Take him high up on a fort and throw him down from there. Or he could be hanged. So see, all these three people, they thought of very strict punishment to be given to this person. That anyone who dares to go near the king and tweak his mustache, that person should be given very strict punishment. Okay, so now see, Akbar is in a mood of amusement. He is not actually going to punish anyone, but he is just in a mood of amusement. So now the story continues. And you, Birbal, what punishment do you suggest for this offender? So now Akbar asks Birbal, okay Birbal, these people have given their reply. Shahbaz Khan, Mullah Dopiaza, Shadi Shah. They have given their reply. Now Birbal, what do you suggest? According to you, what should be the punishment? So now Akbar turns to Birbal. What is Birbal's reply? Okay. Shah Alam. See, it's written over here. Shah Alam. Okay. Shah Alam means, Shah means king and Alam means the whole world, the king of the world. This is the word he is using for Akbar. Shah Alam said Birbal calmly. Calm means he is very relaxed. Okay, he said it calmly. He said it in a very relaxed way. And what did he say? Okay, I would give him some sweets. Okay, and what was Birbal's punishment? I would give him some sweets. See, the earlier three courtiers, they thought about the strictest punishment they could think about. Now over here, what is Birbal saying? That I would give him some sweets. The other courtiers gazed at Birbal. Now everybody started gazing at Birbal. Gazing means, you know, sometimes you look at that person in surprise. Oh, what did he say? Okay, what is Birbal saying? Has he gone mad that he is saying that I would give him some sweets? The other courtiers gazed at Birbal. Had he gone mad? Sweets for such a crime? Surely this time Birbal was wrong. And what did all the other courtiers think? That surely, definitely this time Birbal was wrong. Because sweets cannot be given for such a big crime. The Akbar frowned. Now Akbar also frowned. Now what expression is Akbar showing on his face? Frown means to look at with anger. If you look at someone with anger, so you'll frown. That is the expression Akbar is also giving. Did I hear you right, Birbal? So he is again confirming with Birbal. Did I hear you right? Sahi bola tune. He said, you consider giving sweets to be the right punishment for such a crime? Do you think this is the right punishment? Do you think sweets should be given? Only in this case, your majesty, said Birbal humbly. Now Birbal is saying, yes, emperor, I have what punishment I have said is right. whatever I am saying is correct. Why? Only in this case. Only in this case, this is the correct punishment that I would like to give that person some sweets. Because who else but the beloved grandson would dare to take such a liberty with the king of kings? So this criminal would be no one else but the emperor's grandson. Only who could take the liberty to come near the king and tweak the emperor's mustache would be only his grandson. No one else would dare to do such a thing. Okay. So what is he saying? That only the emperor's grandson would dare to take such a liberty with the king of kings. See again, what is the word used for Akbar? King of kings. Because he was a very big emperor. Okay. So only in this case I would like to give him some sweets. Akbar burst out laughing, and as we read in the beginning of the story, that he was doing it just for fun's sake, just for amusement, he was doing it just for entertainment. This question was not meant to be a serious question. Okay, so Emperor Akbar burst out laughing. You are right again, Birbal. And what did he say? You are right again. Like always. Always as Birbal has the correct answers to Akbar's questions. Same way this time also Birbal has the correct answer. Indeed, it was that little rascal who tweaked my mustache this very evening. So Akbar is saying, yes, indeed, it was that grandson of mine who did this in the evening, and that is why I came across with this question, and that is why I asked you this question. Okay, some of the meanings that are included in your textbook, I have already written them on the board, plus a few other words which you may find difficult in your lesson I have written. First is strolling. That is walk in a slow, relaxed way. Next is amusement. Amusement means entertainment. Tweak. Tweak means tuning or adjusting. Smirk. See, this lesson has not come in our story, but it is written in the exercise in our textbook. That is why I have written it. Smirk. Smirk means smile in an unpleasant way. Say hum kisi ka mazak udane ke liye us par haste hain. So that is called smirk. Insolence means rudeness. Outwitted means trick someone. You use a trick and you outwit someone. So that is outwitted. Gaze. Gaze means look fixedly. If you continually look at some person or something, that is called gaze. Okay, outwitted is trick someone. Villain. Villain means a culprit or a criminal. Gunegar, that is a villain, culprit. A person who does the crime is called a criminal. Mercilessly means without kindness. Mercy means kind. But merciless means without kindness. Flogged, beat with a whip. Flog someone means chabuk se mana, that is called flogged, means beat with a whip. Beheaded means cutting the neck. Offender means culprit. Like over here we have the word culprit. Culprit, villain, criminal, offender. All these other words that you use can be used interchangeably. Frown means look at with anger. If you look at someone with anger, that is called frown. Humbly means calmly. Dumbfounded means extremely surprised. Even this word is not there in your lesson, but since it is mentioned in your exercises, I have written it. Dumbfounded means extremely surprised. After this, what were all these meanings? See that you write them in your notebook, and besides the sentences that are given in the textbook, what you can do is try framing other sentences with these same words. Try framing different sentences which will help you to improve your language. Okay, and plus, what you should also do is read the story again from the textbook. It's on textbook page number 12 and page number 13. Read the story, and it's very, the explanation of the whole story is very easy. Plus, for this lesson, what else you can do is, See, there are a lot of stories of Akbar and Birbal that you can find on the net also. Okay, so just for improving your language, you can need a few more stories. One we have already done in the first lesson. You can need a few more stories. Would be very good. It would be helpful to you for improving your language. Plus, whenever you come across hard words, also have a habit of finding out the meanings and try to use these words in different sentences. Except for those sentences which are written in the textbook, you can frame different sentences and try them.